Welcome to this STM32 Security Feature MOOC. After a first MOOC about the basic of cryptography, now I would like we go much in detail about all the security blocks available across all our STM32 families. We'll try to experience them and to understand really what are the purpose, what we can do with them. In fact, all the STM32 don't have all the security features, so it's really important to understand the capability of each one. And this is the first step, for sure, to understand how we can combine them and to build a security system on STM32. Let's try to list all those features we'll see together. The first one is the resources. It's the STM32 unique ID. I think the name is sufficient. Static protection, what is the meaning of this? Static protection is something that is already configured when your code is started. So it's configured with option byte in our case. So your firmware have not started at all, those protections are already configured. Then we've got dynamic protection. So here, this is configured by the embedded software. That means in your code, you have to activate the protection when you need it. Then we've got crypto hardware resources. So it's hardware acceleration of cryptographic functionality. Then we've got crypto software resources. So it's a software implementation of cryptographic functionalities. If I come back just to have one word for each of those protection. So for the static protection, WRP, write protection. So you can just say a portion of the flash is write only. That means you can't unwanted write it or erase it. Then we've got the PCROP. This is a portion of flash that you can declare as execute only. That means you can read or write it even with the core or with the debugging link. Then we've got the RDP, readout protection. It's allowed to lock the flash if there is a debugging link access. And it's also able to remove the debugging link. Unique entry boots to ensure that the STM32 boot to a specific address and not to another one. The last one of the static protection is the user secure mem, also called HDP in some case. It defines a portion of flash that will be executed at boot time, but that can disappear after. From the just after its execution. That means if you hide something there, just after execution, you say disappears, and it disappears from the system. Dynamic protection. We've got the MPU. If you are familiar with Cortex, you know this one. So it's a memory protection unit that allows memory isolation. Firewall. It allows you to define a security enclave regarding flash and RAM. And you only have one unique software entry point. That means when you want to enter in this region, you have to go just to this unique entry point. Threadzone is the Cortex M33 mechanism, which creates a strong isolation between secure and non-secure domain. OTF DEC, which is on-the-fly decryption of an external memory thanks to AutoSpy interfaces. And the last one, Tamper, which just allows detection of tamper events. Then from the crypto hardware resources, we've got true random number generators, symmetric encryption decryption accelerators, hash computation accelerators, and asymmetric cryptography accelerators. And from the crypto software resources, we've got our CryptoLib, which is an API implementation of the symmetric and asymmetric cryptography. This one is CFVP certified. Now just a huge array that sums up the availability of those different features regarding the STM32 series. This is really a sum up, it's a picture at a time, so on your new device you have to double check what is available or not and what kind of security you will be able to build with this. But now I think it's important to go in detail for each of them and try to experiment them. So, okay, let's discover those features together.